Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning in. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button at Lonnie Bay NJ. And make sure to follow me on Instagram at Lonnie Bay. So for today's video, we're gonna be doing a white LV press-on set. These are going to be going to California, so I'm going to be shipping them out from Pennsylvania, so that's pretty cool. These are going to be mainly white. They are going to have some Louis V sticker decals, and we are going to add a few crystals. Here we are just adding the background color white. We are going to be applying a smooth, even layer, making sure there's not any transparent areas. Now, this tip, we are going to be using the nude color. This is the background for the French V-cut white tip that we are going to be doing. Now here we are applying a second coat of gel, making sure everything's nice and even. I am wiping down the edges to clear any excess gel. And here we are again, just putting our second layer onto the press-ons. I'm not going in any particular order. I'm not going from pinky to thumb or thumb to pinky. I am working with four nails at a time. So here is the process. I believe this is the pointer finger that we're working on. I'm sorry, it's not the pointer finger. The pointer finger, we are gonna be doing a glitter acrylic application. This one may be the middle finger. Yeah, this one's the middle finger. Okay, got a nice white layer. Now I'm gonna be cleansing the tacky layer off of the gel. I don't want that tacky layer because any debris will be attracted to it, and we don't want that, especially when working with white gel or even black, because any debris or lint will show. All right, now I am using my gel. I got back in California when I was living there. I got it from Yasmin's Nail Supply. And we're just gonna be adding our Swarovski crystals. I don't know the particular number size, but these are the smaller ones. I just added my crystals into these clear acrylic pots. I did have them in a acrylic organizer tray, but the problem was that they would mix around through the cracks that the crystals would fit, and I don't like to really go through the crystals and try to look for them. I like to have them organized so that way it's easier for me to grab and go. So these work perfectly. All right, now we're going to be adding some glue, and we're going to be starting off with smaller crystals. This tip is the middle finger. We're gonna be doing a straight line down with the crystals, and we are gonna be adding a Louis Vuitton sticker decal in the middle of the crystal design. All right, now we're adding this last one, I believe. I'm just gonna add a little bit more glue to the end there to add this last crystal. All right, perfect. Here we are going in with the Louis Vuitton sticker decal. I also got these sticker decals from Yasmin's Nail Supply back in California. I like these stickers because when I apply them, they do go on very thin and neatly. I don't have any piece of the sticker sticking upward or anything. It sticks perfectly and it stays there. All right, we went in with a little bit more of the glue and gonna finish off with our crystals. This glue that I use holds very well. Once it's dry, it's there almost forever. But in the meantime, when I am applying it, it does give me enough time to move them around, move the crystals around. Okay, we're just making sure all the diamonds are there neatly. At the edge of the tip, I did have a small space where a diamond probably could not fit, but I still went ahead and made it fit. It had an overlay or an overlap on the crystal under it, above it, but it did look well and it fit well and it wasn't sticking out as much as I thought it would, so it came out perfect. So I was happy with that application. So now here we are with the nude press-on tip that we are gonna be designing with a V-cut white French tip. Okay, now this brush that I am using, I don't remember where I got it from, but I do like it. It helps with lines. It's very sturdy and it doesn't shake when I'm painting the lines. All right, when applying white, you do want to make sure that the white is being applied evenly. You don't want any transparent or blotchy areas. So don't be afraid to get more product and really put it in there. Just make everything even. I am using the same brush to fill in that gap. It's not a very big gap, so I am gonna go ahead and just use the same brush. Now this is the first coat that we're gonna be doing. After this, we are gonna put it in the light for 60 seconds to cure fully. All right, I'm just going in and making sure everything's even, getting any spots that I may think that don't look perfect. Before putting into the light, I do a 360 with the nail to make sure the ends and the edges are perfect, making sure that I have every line parallel, making sure everything aligns perfectly. I cured that for 60 seconds. Now here we are wiping off the tacky layer of the gel. And this is the thumb press on. We're gonna be adding this Louis Vuitton nail decal. Press firmly and evenly. Sticks very well. Okay, so here we have our nail with the Louis Vuitton decal that we applied earlier. I did put it to the side because I wanted the gel, the glue from the diamonds to dry first, then I'm applying the gel now. I'm applying the gel, making sure the ends are nice and crisp, making sure that back part is on well as well. All right, now Once the glue from these diamonds are dried as well, which only take a minute or two, I'm applying clear gel over this. Usually when I'm applying clear coat over stickers, over the nail decals, I do apply two coats. But with these decals, they are very thin and nice. I like the way that they apply onto the nail. It's as if there is no sticker on there. They're very thin and nice, super sticky as well. So I just go in and put one coat of the clear coat. Here we are doing our second coat on the white V French tip. Using the same brush, we're just gonna go along the lines of the first application. Even though this is the second coat, you still wanna make sure the white is being applied evenly, nice and thinly, not too thick. All right. Also, after applying it, you do wanna still check your edges, make sure none of the undercolor is showing under the white. Okay, go in evenly. You want to get those edges perfect. All right, and I like my white to look super white, and as you can see, it's all white. All right, I will put this press on into the light for 60 seconds of full cure. Here we are now with the thumb press on. We are applying clear coat. I am doing the same designs on each hand. In the video, I won't show each nail fully. So now here we are getting ready to apply the glitter acrylic. I'm taking out my monomer and my powders and my glitters, getting my brush ready for the acrylic application. So beforehand, I did prep the nail. I clipped them, I filed them the shape I wanted them. And I do all this before I start to put gel or any type of acrylic, because I do, it makes the job easier instead of having to go in after and do all that. So we are going to be doing a glitter acrylic ombre. So here I'm going in with my natural clear acrylic. And I am making sure that the cuticle area of the press-on tip is not too thick, because when applied, I want the nail to look natural, not bulky and unnatural, obviously. So instead of letting the acrylic drip, because I don't want it to be a thick application, I want it a very thin application, I do bring it down with my brush. I make sure I have a nice thin layer instead of letting it drip and give it a full coverage. So now here I got some clear acrylic and dipped it into my glitter. I really like this glitter. This is my go-to glitter. Has a little bit of like a, I want to say like mermaid color effect. Or a unicorn, but I do very much like this glitter. So when applying it, I dragged as much as I wanted downward. And once I thought it looked okay, I am gonna use the tip of my brush to ombre the glitter upward. I wanted the glitter to ombre into where the natural nail is going to be. So you can always ombre it up higher or even lower. But keep in mind when adding acrylic, you want it as thin as possible. You want to lay out the acrylic as thin as possible. Here I am going to encapsulate the entire nail with clear powder. I like to encapsulate any of my colors, any of my glitters with clear acrylic, so that way when I do go in to file or buff anything out, I'm not buffing or filing into the color or the glitter. I'm more filing into the clear. All right, now this is the second glitter acrylic press on. These are the pointer fingers. So I waited to do the acrylic at the same time for both the nails because I didn't want to be going back and forth with the acrylic. So it made it easier to do these at the same time. All right, and here I am encapsulating the finished product, making sure it is nice, thin, and even. You want a nice thin layer of acrylic. All right, we're gonna put those to the side, let them dry. Here we are finished with one of the white V-cut French tip, and we are gonna start to decorate it. I am using my Swarovski crystals. These are the more smaller ones. And these are going to be just a few, just to give it a little sparkle. Always make sure they're straight before you let them sit out to dry. All right, so this seems to be the thumb. I'm starting on the next hand, it seems to be. I'm gonna apply my white nice, thin, and even. We are gonna be doing two coats on this one as well. All right, and we are curing them for 60 seconds. Here the glue has dried. So now it is safe to apply the gel and to put it into the light for another 60 seconds. Here I'm checking if my acrylic is dry and it is perfect, spot on. So I'm gonna go in and file the edges to my liking. I am gonna hand file over the nail because I already do have a smooth layer. I just wanna make sure I get any bumps that I can't see. And we're gonna applicate clear gel. And since this is the finished product, we are gonna put into the light for 60 seconds. Make sure those edges in the back part of the press-on are clear. Okay, we're rubbing off the tacky layer. And this is the thumb tip. So we're going to apply the sticker decal. Press firmly, make sure all sides of the sticker are fully secure before applying our clear coat. After applying, we are gonna cure this for 60 seconds to make sure it's intact and ready to go. All right, make sure everything's crisp. We're gonna be making sure that the nail is dry before we go into file. We're gonna file it to our liking and then coat with our clear coat. And we are also gonna cure this for 60 seconds to make sure it's good to go. We're gonna start along the middle, right down the middle of the press-on. We're gonna start applying our Swarovski crystals. We're using the smallest ones that I have. And we are gonna be applying just a few of them on the first part of the line down the middle. Making sure they're even before we let dry. Okay, that seems to be good. So now we're gonna go get our Louis Vuitton sticker decals. And we are gonna be applying the Louis Vuitton star right in the middle. All right, first we apply our glue. You don't want to add too much. Always make sure the brush isn't full of the glue, especially when working with tiny crystals, because if you put the crystal into a puddle of glue, it will get drowned by the glue and it won't shine as much. At the end there, I didn't have enough space for a full crystal, but I did make it work. I overlapped it just a bit and I loved the way it looked and I was happy with that look, so I kept it. Making sure all the diamonds are in place, straight as can be. Okay, so we're gonna put that to the side. Let that dry before applying clear coat. This is the pinky nail. It is ready to have crystals applied. Again, use light glue on the glue brush. And we're gonna be adding just a few crystals. Okay, so after adding just a few, we are gonna grab our Louis Vuitton sticker decals and we are gonna add a mini LV right at the tip of the crystals. Press down firmly to make sure it's secure. And we are gonna let the glue dry before adding clear coat. All right, so now that this one is ready for clear coat, we're gonna apply a nice, even, medium layer of clear coat. And we are missing a diamond here, I believe. I accidentally took it off earlier with my finger. So we just went in and added a little bit more glue, grabbed our crystals and placed it perfectly right there. And this is safe to go into the light for 60 seconds for a full cure. We are adding clear coat to cure in the light for 60 seconds and we are all done.
come with me. Leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Come with me, fly you out to Greece. Full speed, je suis ton genie.
Thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys subscribe and follow me on Instagram @LonnieBae.